The remote transform nodes allows you to remotely copy its position, rotation, and scale to another node. With it, you can make another node stop following its parent transform and follow it instead. From following paths to making remote cameras and shader tricks. Here's some examples of where you can use them. To make an object move along a path, you need to have it as a child of the follow path 3D node. If your node is outside it, it won't follow the path. But instead of putting your node inside it, you can create a remote transform node and link its transform to your object. Your object's position, rotation, and scale will now be overridden, and it will follow the remote transform node instead of its parent. When you have a player with a camera inside them and the player dies, the camera will also disappear, making it snap back to its default position, which is quite jarring. To fix this, you can use the remote transform inside the player and link it to the camera outside it. That way, when the player dies, the camera stays in place. But what if your player is a scene? How do you link the remote transform to the camera? You can easily do that by making an export variable for the camera and setting the remote transform's remote path to the camera's getPath function, and on the scene, assigning the camera to the slot. Another situation remote transforms can help you is when dealing with subviewports. Subviewports are used to render the camera inside it into images, which is a very easy way to craft minimaps. Put a downward-facing camera that follows the player around and render it to the UI. But subviewport node doesn't have a position, rotation, or scale, so putting it inside the player to follow its position won't work. What we do instead is create a node where we want the camera to be in, and use a remote transform child to transfer its position and rotation to the camera. And we use a subviewport container node that will render the image to the UI to display our minimap. Finally, we can also use it to help with shader tricks. I had a simple distortion shader here to make a desert haze effect. It's a plane in the distance that uses screen space to distort the faraway dunes. The problem here was, it was also distorting the borders of the objects in front of it. So to fix that, I made a viewport that copied the game's camera, but will only render the dunes, and then use that rendered texture at the screen space instead. You can do that by setting the camera to only render the layer 2 display nodes, and setting only the dunes to be in that layer. I still have a problem with the environment tone mapping adjustment settings messing up the light of the shader texture. But if we disable them, you can see the full effect working now. And that's it! Some very interesting uses of the remote transform node. I hope you liked this video, and until next time.